Hi, well this is my second video on my hot composting pile. The first video I did, I asked for viewer assistance and I'm really overwhelmed by all the wonderful responses that I got. Thank you so much for all of your suggestions, all of your helpful comments, taking all those into consideration, and today I'm going to try and build my hot compost pile. Well, hopefully it will be hot compost pile again. So I've collected some additional materials based on the comments that I got. I've collected a couple of buckets full here of grass clippings, and I've collected about maybe 4 or 5 bags of leaves. And then I've got a little bit of coffee grounds, a little bit of crushed up eggshells, and a bucket full of kitchen scraps. So I'm hoping that by adding all these to my compost pile, it will not only add to the volume of the pile, which was a big issue in my first video, but it will also heat the pile up to break down all the weed seeds and all the little vegetable seeds in there that I don't want sprouting in my garden. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you a little bit on how I'm gonna build my pile and then finish building it, and we'll come back to wrap it up, okay? So first what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna layer in some of these grass clippings. Now, I'm trying to make this pretty simple. I know that there's lots of different ways you could do it, but right now I'm just gonna layer in my materials and definitely give it some water in between each layer, because the components of compost are definitely your greens and your browns. Your greens being your grass clippings, your garden scraps, or your kitchen scraps, your garden waste. The second component being water, which I'm doing right now. And the third component being oxygen, which will happen as we turn the compost every couple of days. So I've got a good layer of the grass clippings in there. Now I'm gonna put down a layer of leaves. Now these leaves here, I just raked up from my front yard and I crushed them up real good in here with my hands. When you add leaves to your compost pile, you wanna make sure they're mulched up or crushed up pretty good. Otherwise they just kind of mat down in there and you don't get a lot of air or water. So you can see it's kind of windy today, so we'll see how this works. But I got my second layer in here, pretty good layer of leaves, and in between each layer you want to water it down again. You need lots of water in there. Your compost should be about the wetness of a wrung out sponge, so you don't want it too wet, but this stuff's pretty dry, so I'm going to water down real well. Okay, now I'm just going to layer in some eggshells and coffee grounds. Okay, and I'm gonna add a layer of my kitchen scraps, which are back here. And these are already pretty wet, so I'm not gonna water it down too much more on top of this layer. Okay, look at all that stuff in there. Okay, and now what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna go ahead and repeat those layers, build my pile up a little bit more, in fact, a whole lot more. It needs to be about 3 feet high. We'll come back and show you it when it's all done. Okay, so we'll be right back. Okay, one thing I forgot to mention in the layers, you wanna add some dirt or some finished compost. Now this is a little compost pile I have over here. It's not quite finished. You can see there's still some good chunks in there. But this just kinda helps start the whole compost process. So I'm gonna layer this in between each of my layers as well. These are good and mulched up leaves. A friend of mine mulched these up for me, and they're almost powder, which is perfect for the compost pile. They're already broken down, and they won't have too much further to go. Hopefully this will really heat it up. This bag is so heavy. Oh, whoa. Okay, so I think I put down a little too many leaves at once. I should do it in a thinner layer and water it in between. So I'm gonna take some of these out. Okay, well I got my tape measure out here and I'm measuring. 3 feet is way up here. I had no idea I had so much farther to go. I never measured it before. So I'm thinking I may shift my plan a little bit. And actually, this fits along well with some viewer suggestions in mounting it up more in like a pyramid shape. Because I'm going to have to add some extra walls on here if I want to get it in a square shape up 3 feet high. So I'm going to do what I can to mount it up in a pyramid shape and see how tall I can get it. Hopefully I can get to 3 feet. So we'll use up my grass clippings, use up this bucket of leaves, and we'll come back and show you how tall it is. Whew. Well, got my last little pile of leaves on here. So water it down and we'll give it a final measure. This is a lot of work to build a compost pile 3 feet high. This is 3 feet here. You can see it hits at about 2 feet 4 inches. So I didn't quite make it to 3 feet, but we're gonna give it a go, see how it heats up. Little trick I'm gonna do, a viewer told me about, is instead of using a thermometer, which I don't have, is just stick a piece of rebar in my pile. There we go. Actually, I'm gonna put it so it goes about in the middle. A couple of days, I'm gonna come out and check this rebar. If it's hot on the end, that means my pile is heating up and we've had some success. So for now, we're gonna leave this pile for about 3 or 4 days. But stay tuned for my next composting video because I am going to try a much simpler method. This is a little bit too tricky for me, so we're going to try a much simpler method with the leaves. We'll come back and show you that probably in a week or so. So for now, thanks for tuning in. We'll definitely keep you posted on the progress of my compost pile here. Hopefully it'll heat up. Let me know if you have any other suggestions of anything else I should try for this pile. I'm hoping it doesn't get too hot to burn my house down. We'll give it a go. All right, thanks a lot for watching. We'll see you next time.